Now Rodgers. Got his man complete over the middle. That's James. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Now they send a man in motion right. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. James, and he will take this one in for a touchdown. Edgerrin James with his second touchdown here in this first half, and his guys have taken the lead. Gano the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. Touchdown here to kick it away. From way up at the 23. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. About set to begin their next drive. The Falcons offense at the line. After that last score we just saw, now 14-7, so a chance to march down the field here, try to tie this football game. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave him with a second and just a few inches left. Throwing is Rodgers. Gets this to Waller on the crossing route. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Pressure comes and down he goes. The job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. As they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Throwing on second and long. Rodgers will get this complete to Cooper Kupp. And they're going to get this down to about the 37. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Dancing to his left. And he wisely will throw that one away. So now on comes the field goal unit. And wow, this is no ordinary try here. Gano's kick is good. And they'll cut the lead back down to four now at 14-10. So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
Back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is. to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
He'll get it inside the 20. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. Now it's Rodgers. And it's caught. Touchdown. A 9-yard touchdown grab as his guys are able to extend their lead. Cano now to add the extra point. It's good, and it's 21-10. Cano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. From way up at the 23. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
After the sack on first down, Rodgers under pressure, and they got to him again. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. That'll be caught by Kopp. A good pickup, but it will come on what should be the final play in this first half. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. It'll be Falcons football, and they trail here as we get back underway on EA Sports. Here comes Devin Hester bringing it out. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further.
The Falcons take over first down here at their own 20-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Charles, some things to like about that first half. Ultimately trailing here, but certainly this deficit is manageable. So curious. That's into a crowd and intercepted. And a great return as he gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line. That one is going to sting. First play of the third quarter and a turnover.
And you have to know that at halftime, they spent a lot of time going through their checklist of what they wanted to accomplish to start this third quarter. Turning it over like this was not on that list.
Not at all. You come out of the locker room trailing, so that first drive to establish momentum is very key.
Crucial.
Now on first down, and his throw's going to be incomplete. To give you an idea of how accurate he's been throwing the football, we're in the second half. That's just his second incompletion.
Well, if he's that locked in, that means everyone's locked in, because to me it's like throwing a no-hitter in baseball. The pitcher may get the credit, but a lot of people making plays behind him in the field.
And this is going to be intercepted. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And the Falcons are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20.
Oh, that's a beautiful read there by the safety. Zone coverage, so he's just going to sit back and watch. He knows he can't get beat deep because he has the end line to protect it. So he can react to everything in front of him, and he makes a great break on the football and comes down with the interception.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. So the offense back out now, coming off its first interception of the game the last time out, trying to reestablish some momentum here, Charles, but they're trailing defensively. Maybe these guys are smelling the blood in the water a little bit.
Yeah, I think that they probably are, but what they need to do right now is just make sure they don't force the action too much themselves. They've got them on the run a little bit. You just want to be in a position where if they make another mistake, you're there to capitalize on it and take it away from them.
To throw again on second down. Rodgers throwing the out route incomplete. That's right. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. To throw is Rodgers. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down. Third quarter from Southern Nevada. Here's a second and 10. Rodgers to throw once more. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Here's Rodgers. Over the middle, complete. It's Hall. And he is going to have a Falcons first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Now Rodgers. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Just what they need, a lecture from me, but subpar offense is what helped get them into this spot. And now they're continuing the trend with incompletions. That won't get them out of it if they don't change something soon.
Connecting with Kupp here on the out route. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. Got a man. It's Darren Waller. Touchdown, Falcons. Darren Waller, 36 yards. And the Falcons have come back within a score.
As a general rule, quarterbacks don't want to lock in on a receiver before the ball is snapped. But in this case, based on the matchup he thought he was going to get, it was favorable for his tight end. He locked in on him early and found him for a touchdown.
And he's got it. So the try for two successful. And with it, they're back within a field goal. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Their lead down to a field goal now as they start with a first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. First down, 10. Rodgers now to throw. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Finally hauled down for the first time this game. Multiple defenders in there to drop him. To try again after the sack. Rodgers. Looking left sideline. It's complete. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it out past the 45. On play action, it's Rodgers. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
A
no one likes to see that drop, but I'll guarantee it's not going to stop his quarterback from going back to him anytime he has open space.
A good action to this point in the third quarter. Just a three-point game. Second and 10. To throw, it's Rodgers. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off. Back now in Las Vegas. Welcome back, everybody. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Rodgers now on first down. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. To throw again on second down. Rodgers, throw complete there to Jerry Rice. And he's going to get this down near the 25. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Rodgers again now. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's going to have a gain of 11 to the 11 before he's brought down. First and 10.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomped down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. The offense back out on the field here following the two-minute warning. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. Totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. And again, it's Rodgers. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And he gets halfway there from the 6 to the 3 on a gain of 3. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. James. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the 1. Give him 2 on the play there. And now they'll be set up with a first and goal. Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Get up.
Down to a knee here. The defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 14 seconds to go in the game. And they will take a knee here. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. And the 13-year man puts it through, and that will add three more to their lead. It pushes it up to six.
Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line.
This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that. Charles's defense, they were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they're both game planned for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
And a fun, close ball game comes to an end. On that last play, Charles, they were on the wrong side of midfield. They needed something near a miracle, and they couldn't get it done.
Yeah, the effort, that was good. Very good, in fact. They were just a little too far out to get a decent look at the end zone for that last opportunity. Couldn't get it done, but a nice game overall.
Till we all big time, face on my rollie on big time, facing my goals, that's a big climb, still my flow is unshakable. Run it up, I cannot quit it, I need it, I ain't where I wanna be, I can admit it. Never submitting, I'm fighting my darkest of thoughts, I am a force. I harbor the light that's inside of my heart, I write in my art and give you my story. You are the witness, I came on a mission to give you my pain and give you my glory.
All this time, I'm on the grind, oh I'm shining, nothing can stop me. All these years, blood, sweat and tears, but I'm still here, nothing. Run it up, 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 run it up. Nothing can stop me. Run it up, run it up, run it up, run it up, run it up. Nothing can stop me.
I overcame all the odds. I ain't been playing it safe, nah. I was just giving my all. I'm taking it there. Hop in the Wraith and we lay in the stars. I made it happen to boss, yeah. I was just playing my cards. I'm taking it there. I'm taking it there. I'm taking it there. It's gonna be a riot, doubt me, it's quiet. I got the can of gas, I'm about to ignite. I am driven, I won't ever get tired, cause I've been left behind, I have to get right. Waiting on the sign, now I just wait on my...
With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gardner. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
And we are underway here in Las Vegas. Pulls it in at the 13. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
You block over here.
first play and a first throw for Rodgers.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Casey Hayward. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Colts TD.
So a big defensive play there on the opening drive, no less, as they make the interception and bring it back for the score.
And I think that's a signal for how this defense wants to play. They want to be disruptive, and you know they're going to take some chances.
Well, sometimes it can burn you, but right there, it paid off. Vinatieri connecting on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Pulls it in at the 13.
Cooper got one return. They'll take over. First down and 10. And they're on 20.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
And sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, "Hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it." All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
Play fake. Rodgers. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Rodgers gonna throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Tariq Woolen picks it, and the Colts are going to take possession of the football.
And partner, I think this is where long-term starters in the NFL separate themselves from the rest of the pack, because there's still three full quarters left in this one, more than enough time to move past a pair of early mistakes and find a way to lead your team to a win. Mental resiliency, a characteristic every NFL team's looking for in their quarterback.
They'll bring a receiver in motion left. Is gonna go down. He's sacked. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're gonna need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Throwing there, but this pass is gonna wind up incomplete. Well, that's not the way you want to start a first pass attempt and a first drop all in one.
Well, you've got plenty of time to make up for it, but obviously not the way you want to get things started. You gotta shake that off and get going.
Here's Rodgers to throw. This pass out wide to Hall. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Blake Gillikin on the punt now on fourth down. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. That one sails out of bounds. The side judge will walk it off. And he says it went out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Nice punt. So well done there. And these punters, they get more specialized and better each and every year, don't they?
They sure do. And now it's really not the American punters. It's the Australian punters with their kicking academies. And that flat drop and just kind of kicking the nose of the football, they're able to almost stop it where they want to, like a good golfer can check one up.
It'll be a gain of 5. And that will bring up second down. Throwing now is Rodgers. And that is going to be incomplete as he let him a bit too much.
And he's only hit on 2 of his first 6 passes. Time for a quick quarterback regroup here with a big third down coming up.
Now Rodgers. Steps away to his left. Got his man complete over the middle. It's James. Rodgers.
Rodgers gonna go on fourth down. And Rodgers intercepted a third time. Such a costly interception, nearly a pick six, but now they're so close, they are knocking on the door for a touchdown.
And I never want to get on any team for being aggressive because that's part of what their makeup is, and oftentimes it's successful. But in this case, you've got to be selective about it and make sure you take care of the football. That interception almost cost them 6 points. Now their defense has to run onto the field, probably giving the quarterback a few side eyes along the way. They've got to see if they can stop the score.
Meanwhile, here's a shot for the end zone right away, but it's incomplete.
Partner, this is almost an unwinnable spot for a defense. They have to come right out for a first and goal trying to stop them. But let me hold on a second. Let me take that back real quick. They can win here if they force a field goal try. Still a long ways away from that happening, but that has to be what they're thinking right now.
On second and goal, Rodgers. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
Coaches talk about it all the time. Players talk about it as well. Excellent job staying disciplined in coverage and making that stop. Inside the red zone, every stop like that could be preventing a possible touchdown.
They'll try to run it here with Hall. And he takes it in for a quick score. Brees Hall taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Colts have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Vinatieri able to tack on the PAT. And that'll make the score 14-0. And here's Vinatieri now to kick it away after the touchdown. Pulls it in at the 13.
He'll take over first down 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They've been outplayed early, no question. Down 14-0 already as they come up first and 10. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he tries to keep the legs churning, but he's going to be stopped behind the line. On second and 12, Rodgers. James has got it. Complete. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
He's now third and 2.
Rodgers looking to throw on third and 2. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Well, they were in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards. Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The offense already on the field here to begin quarter number 2. As they've got it with a first and 10. Now it's Rodgers, and his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Tariq Woolen picks it, and he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race, and he will bring it back. An interception return for a Colts TD.
Adam Vinatieri for the extra points.
Vinatieri connecting on the extra point, and that makes the score 21-0.
Makes the score.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive.
Well, CD, you kind of feel like they're in a bit of a danger zone right here because now you're down 3 scores, and I know we're in the first half, but the way this offense hasn't been able to generate anything, you feel like they probably need to get something going on this drive, right?
Yeah, and sometimes I overuse if this is an important possession.
But I think this has to be the possession where they come up with an answer, because only a few teams in league history have ever come back from a four-score deficit. And if they don't score here, that's what they could be facing the next time they get the ball.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Jerry Rice, open right side. It's a 15-yard pickup, but it'll lead to a fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
Rodgers to throw for it on fourth. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Colts are going to get the football in outstanding field position. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Throwing is Rodgers. He gets it underneath to Hall. And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. To throw is Rodgers. And that is caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Brees Hall. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Colts are able to add on to their first half lead. Vinatieri able to tack on the PAT, and that makes the score 28-0. And here's Vinatieri now to kick it away after the touchdown. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive.
As this offense gets ready here for this drive, Charles, you still wonder about that prior drive. Went for it on fourth down in their own territory, didn't get it, and then that led to a touchdown on the other side.
And I don't mind the aggressiveness. In fact, I'm usually a huge fan of it, but I just want teams to always weigh risk and reward. To me, too early in this game, because reward just wasn't big enough to go for it there in case they failed. Now the pressure back on their offense to pick themselves up and negate the touchdown that was just given up.
Here's James. 7 yards there and a first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
First and 10, 36-yard line.
Rodgers now on first down. Over the middle, complete. It's James. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
It's a gain of 11. That's another first down. First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
On first down, Rodgers. He finds his man complete. That's James. And he'll be brought down just shy of 40. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now Rodgers. Looking right sideline, that's complete. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25.
First and 10 at the 25-yard line.
On first and 10, here's Rodgers. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's going. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Rodgers to throw once more. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
They haven't been able to stop them so far this series, but getting a nice little stand from their defense now.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Rodgers now to throw. He finds his man complete. It's James. And he will take it in for the touchdown. And Edgerrin James. 25 yards for the touchdown. And his guys are able to close that gap just a bit. Extra point try good by Godot. And it's now a 28-7 ball game. Godot now following the touchdown here to kick it away. It's a short kick taken out beyond the 20. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And with a 3-score lead already, this is not time for a momentum change, so I'd imagine they'd be happy to just take this into the locker room. And he's able to get out to the 32, run down there. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go until halftime.
Hey, take 26!
They'll send a receiver here in motion right. Throwing again on second down, Rodgers. And he's caught downfield. It's Waller. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. Now another timeout called for by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. They'll send a receiver in motion left. And Rodgers is going to go down. He's sacked. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and end up getting sacked. That's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. They'll send a receiver in motion to the left. Throwing on second and long, Rodgers. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. The pressure really ratcheting up. They get the sack on first down, then a near sack. They got to him there just as he was leaving his hand.
Yeah, they might need to change their pass protection scheme a little bit. Maybe bring another guy into the backfield to help protect the quarterback, because that was awfully close.
Final shot before half for Rodgers. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. Second half ready to get underway. The Colts with a lead, and they will receive the football. A fairly short kick from the 14. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive.
Hey, you block over here.
Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Got a man. It's Darren Waller. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49.
That's good. First down.
30.
First and 10.
They bring a receiver in motion left. Rodgers now on first down. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Deion Sanders, the Hall of Famer, with a pick. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30.
First and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
26.
So after the INT, it's Rodgers. Looking left side, and it's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. From midfield, here's Rodgers. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Here's Rodgers. And he comes back with one complete. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts 33. Slot man moves right. Rodgers again now. He'll get this complete to Cooper Kupp. And they're going to move it down inside the 25. From the 24, Rodgers. He finds his man complete. It's James. And he's brought down here just outside of the 20. To throw, it's Rodgers. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's James. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. It's a gain of 11. That's good. For another first down and goal to go. Rodgers gonna throw. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down. They'll go again here from the 10-yard line on second and goal. There's Rodgers to throw. Caught on the slant. And he gets into the end zone for the touchdown. Jerry Rice from 10 yards out. And his guys are able to cut into that deficit. Gano the extra point, and that cuts the lead to 28-14. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. Their lead down to two scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a first and 10. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Now Rodgers. Can't get away, and he's taken down. Rodgers, and this one is incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Rodgers gonna go on fourth down. And it's going to be batted down. And we'll go the other way with a football. A surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And it'll be a turnover on downs. Throwing now is Rodgers. Got his man complete over the middle. That's James. Down inside the 10. He's going to be out of bounds on what's going to wind up being the final play of quarter number 3. Back now in Las Vegas. Welcome back, everybody. As we're about ready to rock and roll for the fourth and final quarter. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. The slot man in motion right. They'll run on first down. James. And he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. Edgerrin James, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And his guys are able to make this a close game again. Extra point try good by Gano. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. It's a short kick taken out beyond the 20. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You've got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have three timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit, and you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all of their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it three times and cut it, you got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the two-minute warning in play, so essentially four timeouts. So
they have to be aggressive here.
Rodgers on first and 10. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play.
Not only did we just see back-to-back nice gains, but we're also seeing the confidence rise, not just for the guy who caught it, but the guy throwing it as well.
And these back-to-back catches here out of the backfield, that can set something up downfield in a later sequence, right?
A lot of the time, it starts to draw the defense closer to the line of scrimmage. So to your point, show this swing pass, show this check down. Maybe later on you heave one deep when you catch him close to the spot.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Play action. Now it's Rodgers. Oh no, he lost the football. And he will score. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Well, not exactly the way that they drew it up, Harder, but certainly not going to complain because the end result, touchdown.
A great outcome for the offensive side, but a crushing play defensively. You make a quick stop, force a fumble, and you see them take the fumble all the way in for 6 points. Now the challenge becomes not getting down and going out and continuing to make plays and hoping the ball bounces your way the next time.
Vinatieri connecting on the extra point, and the lead now up to 14. Vinatieri now to kick it away after the touchdown. Pulls it in at the 13. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive.
As the offense begins another drive here, pretty simple, Charles. They want to carbon copy what happened the last time out when they ended their drive in the end zone.
You're right about that, partner. Sounds pretty simple, doesn't it? Just score again. But we know it's not that simple because we don't just make adjustments at halftime if you're a good football team. You spend that time on the sideline, you study what's on the notes and the tablets, and you make those adjustments to prevent a repeat of the last drive. Series to series, the best teams, that's how they get it done.
And we'll find out here soon enough whether those adjustments are enough defensively. So the big play gets them all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Now it's Rodgers. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. Back to throw again. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. This will be a short gain of 3 before he's brought down at the 22. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. Now a play fake. Rodgers. That is caught at the 7. And they work this near the five. He'll be stopped at the six. They'll look to throw again. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Limited time left on the clock after that incompletion, so I think both sides are going to savor every second to prepare before the next snap. Because once the ball's in motion, it may be a nonstop push to finish this drive off. Everyone better be on the same page right now, because I think they're going to try and get several plays off in quick succession if they can.
That time the completion goes for 4 yards, and we're set up with a third and goal.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense, because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Edgerrin James taking it in for 2 yards out. And his guys have made this a one-score game now. Gano the extra point. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Touchdown here to kick it away. Here comes Devin Hester bringing it out.
Devin Hester on the return. The Colts take over first and 10 at their own 14-yard line.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And this game not quite over yet. And we'll likely see him take all three timeouts defensively, so they can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use up all their timeouts in order to feel like they have this one in hand.
So they come up on second down, and they can get another run like we just saw. We'll likely put an end to this thing. All again on second down. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. To throw is Rodgers. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line.
And they'll take possession already in the red zone and in a great spot to add points to the scoreboard.
And Brandon, how many times have we seen a defense with a lot of field behind them get even more aggressive, right? They feel like they've got them not pinned down, but in a favorable spot for them. And they took advantage of it there, got a nice interception, and set up their offense in great shape.
This is caught, and he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense, as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. A looming decision to make on the conversion, down 7, but first things first, they need to score as they come up on first and goal. Taken down. From back at the 4, here's second and goal. Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. Back to throw, Rodgers. And that's intercepted yet again, and that could be the backbreaker. And the Colts have just about sewn up this football game. I think you and I were a little surprised back earlier in the game when he threw his second interception. I mean, who would have thought a quarterback of his caliber picked now 5 times?
It's beyond stunning to me because we're used to that with maybe a quarterback with less experience or less talent.
I got some true stories to tell. You're back outside, but they still lied. Whoa, yeah.
Take off the foo-foo. Take off the cloud chase. Take off the Wi-Fi. Take off the money phone. Take off the car.